Today on Toy Shiz, Scotty doesn't know, so don't tell Scotty. Welcome back, everyone. Toy Shiz here, and I am back yet again to give you guys another fresh look. And today we are totally checking out the upcoming brand new Marvel 3.75, or as I call them, the Marvel 375 figures. This is the Hasbro Pulse exclusive. It's all nice and shiny, nice artistic packaging on this. You get all the characters, but this one features Wolverine and Phoenix. Marvel's Phoenix, to be exact. Here's the barcode as well, just in case these ever hit Walmarts at some point down the road, right? But I like the old classicness of Marvel. Moon Knight's right there, even. There's Spidey right there. That's just very cool. That's why I like these old retro style figures. You got Hasbro Pulse on the top. That's why it's the exclusive, and you open it up, and you get two distinct carded figures, being Wolverine. It's the first time Wolverine's been in the Marvel 375 line. I also like the shininess of the package. You also got the Hellfire Club guy right there, and it's unpunched, for all of you wondering out there. And the backside is shiny as well. You get kind of like a cutout trading card sort of deal that these all have, and a bit of a bio for Wolverine. You know what Wolverine is at this point. They make tons of figures about him. I really like this, by the way. That's a nice little touch. But yes, Wolverine, all his adamantium glory. And then you got the Phoenix, Jean Grey, in her green and gold outfit, red hair, all that jazz. It's a Phoenix, right? Can't go wrong with that. She's got the shiny going on as well. Figures right there in the blister. Card on the back, bio on the back. But again, I like the simplistic drawing right there. So this is going to be a blast. Sit back, relax, grab yourself a nice hot cup of coffee. This is an early look at the upcoming Hasbro Pulse exclusive Marvel's 375 set featuring the X-Men's Wolverine versus Jean Grey Phoenix by Hasbro. And of course, here is Phoenix and Wolverine all out of the packaging, and it's pretty cool. Jean's kind of like a repaint. Wolverine, he's a brand new figure. But we'll look at Jean first. Her face sculpt, we'll just say the face itself is okay. She's basically just a repainted figure, the sash and all. New head sculpt, new hair, so that's nice to see. Really nicely done. Towards the top, kind of gets like Cheeto-y when it starts doing the whole ruffleness in the back. But I like the front of the hair. That's pretty cool. And she does get some rotation out of it, more so on this side. This side, because the hair kind of clumps right there, yeah, it'll kind of hinder her a little bit. But you get the usual rotation. You got the arms and the forearms, nothing at the waist, and she just kicks out. There's nothing at, let's say, elbows and knees if you've never seen these figures before. They're kind of just meant to be this simplistic look, but that's part of the charm of these figures. They're supposed to be old-fashioned intentionally, the whole retro-ness of them. Wolverine, he's my favorite, of course, out of the set. You get a new body type for Wolverine, and he's got that classic Jim Lee yellows and blues. I really like that. The face is pretty good. I like the mouth open on one side. Kind of looks like he needs a cigar, right? Sticking out of there. He's got some adamantium claws. I like the shorter claws for these. They make a little bit more sense in terms of where they go when they pop out. You know what I mean? Kind of thing. Head, legs. Unfortunately, on mine, looks like he was pressed up against the plastic when he was painted, so he's got little marks on the back. And because of the simplistic articulation, you can see he just kind of put the arms and you just twist them at the forearm. You got to see that his arms are going to pop off a little bit easy right there. It makes me think, are they going to go the route of having alternate hands at some point? Wouldn't mind that. That would actually be kind of cool. But that's a cool looking Wolverine. It's like a little Mego pocket superhero, right? And the fun of these is when you start building them out. Now you got Cyclops in the mix. He's looking too happy. Wolverine won't even look at him, right? But you can see, yes, Jean Grey, for the most part, is repainted parts and pieces here and there, sash, but a new head sculpt. And again, you can start building out, let's say, giant size X-Men. That looks pretty cool. Magneto going up against Wolverine. Get yourself a flight stand. They're very simplistic. You can't do a lot with these things. They basically just stand there, but I dig them. Or, of course, if you wanted to have Jean Grey going up against her X-Men teammates, they're not going to win. And you kind of have a sort of original X-Men team going. You can do Spider-Man animated series, technically. You can have the Hobgoblin join them and have the mutant agenda. Why not, right? We need a Hobgoblin figure, by the way. Wolverine versus the Hulk. Yeah, you can definitely do that now. That looks pretty cool. Wolverine, Captain America. You see where I'm going with this. There's lots of different combinations, and they're all that classic Marvel appeal that is so cool. And these really do all look great together. There are so many characters now, and just to be able to add Wolverine and Jean Grey Phoenix, yeah, That's pretty darn cool. These are available on Hasbro Pulse to pre-order now if you would like them. It is a really nice set, I would say, if you're a mint on card collector. Really nice, sturdy packaging, really elegant artwork, nice shiny foilness to it. It's great overall. It's a nice, pretty packaging. I would say if you're one of those that will be opening, perhaps wait if and when they ever do release these. We have seen prior foil type carded exclusives released later down the road in the actual waves that hit stores. So in that sense, if you're going to open them, maybe wait until they go that route. But in either case, if you need these now, yeah, go and grab them. And you could always grab them again once they hit the stores. It's up to you. But I am curious to know what you guys think about this new set. Is it for you? Will you be grabbing? And what's your thoughts on the Marvel 375s? Comment below, let me know. Let's talk everything Marvel 375s. I guess that works. So I'm going to leave you guys with that. As always, drink some great coffee, eat some great food, but most importantly, remember, if I don't talk with you, have a fantastic, awesome, healthy, happy Thanksgiving. Eat some amazing food, have some pie, have some coffee, pie and coffee, maybe 1 or 2 hours later after feasting. That's just my style, but you do you. And when you do, let me know what you found. I'll talk to you guys soon. Adios.